This bird, like all living animals, has cells that carry out cellular respiration. During cellular respiration, organisms break down nutrients in order to produce energy in the form of ATP. Let's take a closer look to see how this happens. If we zoom in on one of this bird's cells, we can see the mitochondria, where the majority of the reactions involved in cellular respiration occur. Let's zoom in further on a single mitochondrium. Cellular respiration consists of four primary stages. These are glycolysis, the preparatory reaction, the citric acid cycle, and the electron transport chain. The first stage, glycolysis, occurs in the cytoplasm outside of the mitochondria. During glycolysis, enzymes break down glucose into two molecules of pyruvate. During this process, two ATP are produced, and NADH is released to be used in a later step of cellular respiration. Stage 2 is the preparatory reaction. During this stage, the pyruvates of glycolysis move into the mitochondria, where they are converted into acetyl-CoA. During this conversion process, more NADH is produced, and carbon dioxide is released. In stage 3, the citric acid cycle, the remaining carbons from the initial glucose are oxidized, releasing carbon dioxide. NADH and FADH2 are also produced, in addition to two ATP molecules. Most ATP production occurs in stage 4, the electron transport chain, or ETC. In this stage, the NADH and FADH2 from the previous stages give up electrons to the chain. Energy is released and captured as the electrons move from a higher energy to a lower energy state using a series of proteins embedded in the membranes of the mitochondrion. Later, this energy will be used for the production of ATP, typically 32 to 34 per initial glucose. Oxygen is used by the ETC as a terminal electron acceptor. It then combines with hydrogen ions to produce water. If we add up all the ATP produced from just one glucose molecule, we can see that these reactions produce a total of 36 to 38 ATP.